She falls down, surprised. She falls down and slumps there, hard and heavy like something not alive. The camera rolls and she looks into it. But then her head rolls back, her shoulders roll back. The wall holds her up like a scarecrow. When she wakes up, her eyes snap open. She is tight and afraid, but she stands up and up, and she's going to do it. She's awake, and her eyes are open, but then they're not, and they close, and they've got her once more. In the video, she is dancing and telling her body what to do, but sometimes her body is the one telling her what to do. Sleep swirls around her, tightens around her, is always present around her. There is nothing beautiful about it. No prince to come kiss her awake, just hallucinations, hypnagogic and otherwise. Just a body on the cusp of life and death. Just a body sleeping, somewhere in between. If sleep is the world that bridges wakefulness and death, then narcolepsy is a face and a person and a body that sometimes wants to play dead. Her body is tired of listening, is tired of playing, Simon says, and now it wants to lead. Narcolepsy is a disease, but it is more than that. More than cataplexy attacks or orexin gone MIA, more becomes paralyzed than just your muscles. There is more at stake here. Every year, 1,500 deaths and counting, she meets the glare of the headlights on the road with her eyes closed. 1,500 deaths and counting. She does not want to be counted.